today we are heading off on our next adventure. We are heading to Stradbroke Island. It is currently about 3 p.m. in the afternoon and we are only just leaving now. I actually had to work this morning, so I've completely derailed our plans. The last barge leaves across to Stradi at about 5 p.m. this afternoon. We have about an hour's drive down the highway to get to Cleveland from where it leaves. It will be a little bit of a tight trip, but I think we'll be able to do it. We are heading over to Stradbroke Island for 5 days. Today is Wednesday. We're coming back on the Monday. And Zach's family actually coming over on the Friday, so they'll be with us for the week. We are going to be staying in an apartment overlooking the water at Point Lookout when everybody gets there on Friday. But for the first couple of days that we were there, we thought we'd do something pretty cool, and we're actually going to be glamping. So there are glamping tents over at Adder Rock at North Stradbroke, and they've only just been around for the last couple of months, so we thought we'd give them a try. We love camping, but since we're only going to be out of a space to stay for 2 days, it didn't seem like it was going to be worth tracking everything over across the barge just for 2 nights of camping. So we are glamping and I am really excited about it. Anyway, we are going to make tracks. We have a bit of a drive to do before we can get to the barge, and I will talk to you guys when we are on Stradbroke Island. Just arrived to Stradbroke Island. It took about 45 minutes on the barge. I'm pretty excited that we made it on time to the actual barge, and it was not nearly as choppy as we thought it might have been. We have arrived in a place called Dunwich, which is on the western coast of Stradbroke Island, and we have about a 20-minute drive now up to the top of North Stradbroke at Adder Rock Campground, which is where our glamping tent is tonight. We have had a pretty long afternoon, so I think we'll both be pretty happy to make some dinner and go to bed. But I am excited to be sleeping in a glamping tent tonight. So we arrived to check in at our glamping tent, and we've actually ended up in a tent that is not the one I booked, but it's slightly better. It actually has its own fridge and like a coffee pod machine. I don't know what happened, but we'll find out in the morning, obviously, because no one's in the office at the moment. We can't confirm whether this was an accident or not, but as nice as it is, where I actually want to stay is these little actual proper tents, whereas this is more like a cabin. And those tents are under all these fairy lights and it's really pretty. So I will have to talk to them first in the morning to see what's happened. We have woken up and made our way to Point Lookout this morning for breakfast. So we just had brekkie at the Blue Room, which was pretty good. Today we're going to have a pretty low-key day. We're actually going to visit a couple of beaches that are around, and quite popular ones. We thought we'd go in and have a bit of a look around before heading over to Amity Point Jetty this afternoon to watch the sunset, which I think will make for some pretty good photos. But yeah, that's the plan for today, so we're going to get out and explore around.
Thank you. just arrived at Brown Lake, which is actually not brown at all. It's really blue and it's really pretty. It's kind of like a mini Lake Mackenzie if you've ever been to Fraser Island. It is currently just into spring here in Australia, so it is still a little bit too cold to swim. But in summer, this would be the perfect place to go. So we had the chance to talk to reception and they let us know that all of the glamping tents that we actually booked were cleaned last week. So they smell like chlorine and they thought that they would upgrade us so that we don't have to stay in a tent that smells like chlorine for a week. So that's okay because we're totally happy with our upgrade, but it's good to know why. We'll have to save staying under the fairy lights for next time. How pretty this sunset is. Open eye, feel the waves cut through me, hypnotized by the sounds I'm breathing in. Hold tight, hold tight. Friday, we have spent our last night in our glamping tent, which I'm a little bit sad about. I will be sad to leave here. It's been really cozy, really comfy, and it literally has everything we could ever need. That's the toaster going off over there at the moment for brekkie. So today, Zach's family are arriving. They're arriving about midday, I believe. So this morning we thought we might go down to Frenchman's Beach. We were there yesterday and thought it was really cute. It looks like we might have some good waves this morning, so Zach's gonna go for a bit of a surf and I'm probably gonna catch some sun. But that is the plan so far. And then this afternoon we will be heading over to Point Lookout to stay in our apartment over the water. All because of you. Lookout, which has an amazing view. You walk out into the patio and you get full like 360 degrees of Main Beach and the Southern Gorge, and it is just breathtaking. So I'm totally happy with where we are. Today we haven't got much planned. We're just about to have some brekkie and a pretty cozy morning. And then we thought we would try out doing the gorge walk today. So we've been told the best time to do the gorge walk is either at sunrise or sunset, and obviously we've missed sunrise, so we are going to aim for sunset. But yeah, that's the plan. There's not too much else on. I think we'll probably duck down for some fish and chips for dinner tonight. But I'm just looking forward to another day. Make it last forever. Stop in time. Yeah, I'm surrendering. So we've just decided to go barefoot bowling. There is a place apparently around the corner that does it, and it costs about $10 for 2 hours. So we are gonna go give that a go just for something different to do. Dripping lights, paint the skies, all because of you. Dripping lights, paint the skies. All right, so it's almost 4 in the afternoon and we are just heading out now to go to the gorge walk, and hoping that we can catch a bit of the sunset colours out over the water at the gorge, but we'll let you know how we go. Good morning, it is Sunday. We have woken up a little bit early. It's currently about 5:30 in the morning. And we have snuck down to the beach so that we can watch the sunrise. To start Sunday. Been wanting to do ever since we got to Stradbroke, and that is snorkeling. So here at Straddy, we're actually really close proximity to some of the most popular dive spots within the whole Brisbane region. And today we're going out with a company that's going to take us to two of the most popular. They are providing all of the gear, so all of the snorkeling gear, all of the wetsuits, which we're absolutely going to need because it is freezing in the water at the moment. And we are hopeful that we're going to catch some manta rays, some sea turtles, maybe a dolphin or two. We'll see how we go. I've got super high expectations for this. I am honestly so excited. But I'm going to bring you guys along so you can see a little bit of what we see, and hopefully we'll catch a few sea creatures or two. Good morning.
It is Monday and it is our last day here on the island. We have just woken up and gone and had breakfast back at the Blue Room again. And yeah, basically we are leaving today at about 1:30. So we've just got the morning here. We thought that we would duck down to the gorge again. And then I think we're just going to grab some gelati from the famous Oceanic gelati shop this morning. And then yeah, that will be it. We'll be home. But I hope you guys have enjoyed seeing a little bit of Stradbroke Island and seeing what we get up to. We will be back shortly for our next adventure, sooner than you think. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. I will see you guys shortly in the next one.